Alright guys, so in the past we learned how to distinguish between molecules that were completely different, meaning that they didn't share molecular formula at all, or molecules that we called constitutional isomers. And remember, those were molecules that had the same molecular formula, but they were connected differently. Well, it turns out that there's more types of isomers than just that. There's also other types of isomers that have the same molecular formula, that have the same connectivity, but they just simply have a different shape. The name of these types of isomers is called stereoisomers, and that's going to be the topic of this whole chapter. All right? So what I want to do at the very beginning, just to get started, is go through these different types of isomers so you guys can visualize these for yourself. Okay? So basically, we use isomers to describe the relationships between similar molecules. We wouldn't even be talking about the concept of isomers if it weren't for the fact that some molecules look like they might be the same, and we want to analyze, are they the same or are they different? Okay? Well, it turns out that we can order these in terms of the most different to the most similar. And the most different relationship that you can get between two molecules would actually just be different compounds. Okay? So that's what we're going to fill in right here. I've given you guys examples like these before where we determine, okay, I have two molecules and I want to know what's their relationship. In this case, how would we figure that out? Remember that we used the flowchart that I gave you. And what I said is, okay, first of all, how many non-hydrogen atoms does this have? Well, this one has five carbons, and this one has five carbons, okay? So far, so good. It seems like, okay, these are the same, these might be the same molecular formula. But then we talked about another category or another thing that we need to look at, and that's the IHD, or the index of hydrogen deficiency, okay? Now remember that the index of hydrogen deficiency had to do with rings, double bonds, and triple bonds. So what would be the IHD of this first molecule? Well, in this case, there's only one ring, so that means this would have an IHD of 1. And remember, what IHD of 1 means is that we're missing 2 hydrogens. All right? Now let's look at the second one. The second one doesn't have any rings, it doesn't have any double bonds, it doesn't have any triple bonds, so this one would have an IHD of 0. Okay? That means that this one is missing no hydrogens. Okay? This one is saturated. Okay, so I'm just going to put that. This one is saturated, whereas the first one is missing two H's compared to the second one. Now, I just want to let you guys know, if you're completely lost by what I just did, you've never seen this before in your life, go back to the topic that is called IHD, and I talk about how to figure out index of hydrogen deficiency with molecular formula and index of hydrogen deficiency with a shape. All right, so go back and look over that. It's about 20 minutes long, and that will help you guys so much. All right, and then you might want to go over constitutional isomers as well, because that's what we're doing right now. Okay, so when we look at the relationship between these, what I want to do is I want to use this box to figure out what is shared between the two molecules. So is the molecular formula shared? Actually, no, because think about it. They had the same amount of carbons, but they had different amounts of hydrogens. So they're different compounds. Okay, is the connectivity the same? No, because they're different atoms, and the shape is also not the same. So basically, if your molecular formula is off, none of these other things can be shared, because you already messed up the first step, which is that they don't even have the same atoms. Does that make sense? So these would be different compounds.